Hello, everyone, this is Prince Cypher for VG Gameplay. I'm still continuing my Canadian adventure, playing games with a random girl who took me off the streets.
Hello.
Her name is Jenna Bunnikins.
That would be me.
Yay. And we're playing Mario Land for the... Oh, shit, I nearly died. For the Game Boy. If you watch my Kirby video, you already know my funny story behind first time playing this game. If you haven't... I asked for a Game Boy for Christmas, and so did my brother, and so did another guy, and we all got one, but me and my brother got Tetris of ours, and the other guy got Tetris and, oh yeah, by the way, the hearts are actually this rather than green mushrooms, and the other guy got Mario Land and Tetris, so we were very upset.
As you would be.
Yeah, exactly. Mario Land 2 is a lot better. It's a lot more detailed, a lot more levels, it looked more like a Mario game. A lot more power-ups as well. It had, like, hats and stuff. Well, it had a hat, anyway. It had a bunny hat, I think it was.
Hats?
It was like, I'm pretty sure it was a bunny hat, because he sort of flew with his bunny ears. Pretty weird, but, yeah. Oh, I can't believe I missed that.
How wasteful.
Yeah, so that had no this game like, had none of the Mario music or anything like that. And not even when you collect a star, it doesn't go do that, the usual music. It does the, which is kind of weird.
Your rendition is wonderful.
Yeah, I don't know the name of it. I'm not into that kind of music. But but yeah, it does that instead of the... I can't even remember what the usual one is. Can you remember what it is?
I can't think under pressure.
Just going to think of it randomly. I had this whole... this whole thing at the end of the special stage.
Yeah, that's better than the original one. Or the... more popular version stuff.
Words. What are you saying?
I'm just going to stop saying words.
There you go, got two lives.
Not bad.
Oh no, we didn't start the clock.
Oh no, you ruined it.
Oh no! Okay, so that was me playing, by the way. This is Jenna Bunnikins playing now. You okay?
Mm-hmm. Meep.
Meep. Oh yeah, they're a pain in the arse, those things.
Meh. So what were you saying with the original maker of the game or something?
Shigeru Miyamoto didn't have anything to do with this game, and it was like the first Mario game that didn't have him involved, and like the most well received, because all the other ones are crap. They're like for the CDI and stuff. You've seen the Angry Video Game Nerd of the CDI ones, right?
I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, they were like rubbish cartoony looking things, and you know, just shutting hotel doors and stuff. So this one was like not made by Shigeru Miyamoto, and it was like one of the best received Mario games there is, because it is really, it's actually a really good game. No doubt about it. Kay. I never understood why they couldn't actually just transfer the NES one over, but, yeah.
That makes more sense.
I know there's no colour, but yeah, you're right. But, I mean, it's still an 8-bit console, the same as the NES, so. That was a good fucking shot.
I hit him?
Yeah, the guy in the sky.
That's fairly random. I mean, I meant to do that.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a bitch. The way he jumps is kind of odd.
I can't blame it on the jump. That was all my stupidity.
I don't know, man. He does jump a bit weird. So, I mean, you've played this game before, right?
Yeah, when I was a kid. Just... I couldn't remember when I first saw it.
Pretty retro, you just grabbing your Game Boy out there and pulling it out in front of me.
Well, you know, I'm just returning the favor for all the things you've pulled out in front of me.
Every gameplay video we do with you is just sexual innuendos all the way.
That's what you like about me though, right?
Deary me.
Dear you.
Deary me. Do you want to do your special stage? See if you can get anything? See if you can get something special?
I already have you.
Oh, he got a fire flower.
Lame.
Yeah, nice. You want three lives, right? There you go. It's gone a bit weird. It's gone from like normal outside sort of land to bloody Egyptian style. Watch out for fallen platforms.
Oh, that was gonna be some sort of underworld thingy in these games. What are you doing?
I don't know.
Oh, that works.
I'm going to collect
two money. More and you would have got another three.
Yeah, you know, there'll be more. There's coins everywhere. It's Mario. What do you expect? That guy just nearly taint cane my ass. I'll just go fire's fire. Ruff.
I would not have instinctively wanted to jump on him.
Oh, he's gonna fall.
How did you know that?
I just remember from playing this game as a kid. You know, the funny thing is that I never had, for a long time, I didn't have a rechargeable battery pack for my Game Boy. So I used to play games at night time. I had one of these big magnifier things with a light on it. I see you had a light thing in your box a second ago.
Yep.
I had a big magnifier one on it, and I used to play games at night time when it was like meant to be going to bed and stuff. And I used to think that the batteries would hold out till morning, so I'd pause the game and like put the Game Boy on the floor and I'd wake up and it'd be dead. And I'd be all sad because I got all this way. I know one game, it was on Looney Tunes for the Game Boy. And it was, I got all this way to like Bugs Bunny stages and it just bloody burned out on me.
I understand your logic as how playing at night would make it last longer.
No, it wasn't that I was playing at night. It just happens to be the time because I was meant to be in bed, so I just decided to play it. So we're going to call that the end of part one anyway. Thank you for watching. And yeah, I'm going to get these 3 lives. There you go.
Show off.
That was actually just really good timing. Okay, see you next time, peeps.